The Shadow of the Gods by John Gwynne. I really love this book, and it should be a spoiler review for me and Ethan in the description or up in the cards, whatever I choose to do. But yeah, this is my spoiler-free review, and this is just basically, yeah, like, I'm talking about it spoiler-free, even though this is a lot of, one of those hard to talk about without spoilers. But if you really want a spoiler review, and if you've read the book, go down in the description, and I have a great video you should watch. Now, The Shadow of the Gods was an amazing book. I had a lot of fun, even though it's a 4.5, not a perfect book. There were some nitpicks I had with it, but other than that, it was a really good book. Now, I buddy read this with Ethan, the e-reader. Definitely go check him out. And we had a great time. It was Norse-inspired. I really love the things that are Norse-inspired, or like the inspired. He did Celtic and the Bloodsworn and the Faithful and the Foam. And I feel like Magnus Chase is literally just based off of Norse, and there's Norse gods, and then... But this has the slightest hint of Norse. I think the Bloodsworn resemble a lot to the Vikings. Like, and I feel like it's just like the slightest hint. And I love Norse mythology, if you know me. And then like, do the taste of it. And like, I just like love like the little hint of that in this novel. And it was a great, great taste. And I really think he integrated it extremely well. Yeah, I just had so much fun with it. Like it was, I just had a lot of great times with this book. And even though like it is a dark book, there were some dark scenes, don't get me wrong, but there's like fairy tale aspects, just like the animals talk in this world. And I found that hilarious because like Brekka kind of adopts a tenor, which is like a, I don't know, like a little dragon that are not dangerous. And I just think it's so funny. And then the spurt, had a lot of fun with that. Also, some hard-hitting scenes, like, I'm not gonna talk about, because I talked about them in spoiler review, and, yeah, I just can't really talk about it, because you haven't read it, if you're watching, or you probably have read it. You might have read it. If you have, you know what I mean. It is just, like, the hints of it is so perfect and a little juicy. Now, into my criticisms. Well, always with multiple POV books, there's the one POV that you're not as strong on as the rest of them. And this one, I still enjoyed, it's just, I could tell it wasn't as strong. Malice, I couldn't stand Verdas for some reason. I didn't hate him, it's just, I couldn't read his chapters for some reason. They were so, like, I didn't feel compelled to that character. But here, I just didn't enjoy it, but I did feel compelled to read it. So it wasn't as bad, but still a little bit of that syndrome. And a trope I noticed in this book, again, was like the thing with the knockout of the head, and then kind of wakes up in the next chapter, completely fine. I don't know if I think I mentioned that in my wrap-up. And, yeah, like, it's that kind of stuff. And some other things, like the... Brekka is a really great character, but he's a little young, don't you think? But then he kind of gets, he's a main character, I would say. But he's also kind of a plot point. I'm not going to mention that. I almost get close to a spoiler there. Just a really, really good book. And I definitely, definitely recommend you should check it out. I think this is better than Malice. It was definitely a great step up for Malice, especially in like how it was executed. The idea on par. And then it was executed also much better than Malice. I think the Malice's writing is where it kind of falls apart. And I love how the chapters are perfect. They're not too long and they're not too short. Malice's chapters are like, it could be 5 to 1/2 pages. And that drove me a little bit crazy. And I think this one kind of does it better. It kind of John Gwynne knows what people like, and he's doing it really well. And I'm super excited to read the next book, which I can't wait to just even see the cover. The cover probably is going to be amazing if it's staying up to par with The Shadow of the Gods. I'm so glad I finally read this. This came out in May or March, I believe, one of those. I'm just super happy. I had a great time with it. Gave it a 4.5. Again, it wasn't perfect, but I really, really did enjoy it a lot, and I had a lot of fun with it. And that's the most important, right? And one thing about this cover, holy cow, it's just like a bombshell. It's like so crazy. I remember not knowing anything about John Gwynne, but then seeing this cover released, and I'm like, dude, that's crazy. Like, I need to get my hands on it, even though I've never read anything from John Gwynne. I'm so glad I eventually read it, because that dragon is just so in-depth and detail, and then the guy is just so small. It feels really, really, like, in-depth. I don't really like white book covers, which is a controversial opinion, apparently. And, like, I just think it does. I don't like the white background, but the art is chef's kiss. Perfect. And yeah, again, this is one of my better books I've read in the year, even though probably top 10, top 5 in this year. And I'm so glad I did read it, and I'm so glad that John Gwynne is an author, and I'm super excited to continue with the Faithful in the Fallen series, which I will be, and continue with the Bloodsworn saga. Is it the Bloodsworn saga or just Bloodsworn? But I'm super, the Bloodsworn are super cool, and I loved Varg. Varg was my second favorite character next to Orca. And yeah, everyone in this book I did enjoy. And my favorite character in general was the half-troll, Elnar. Is it Elnar half-troll? What I believe it is called. And then you'll know why if you read the book. But yes, feel free to start some discussions down in the comments below. And yeah, see you guys in the next video. I'm sorry this is a little short, but the full 30-minute review is on Ethan's channel. If it's not out by this review, I'll link it later. But yeah, see you in the next video.